I keep hearing the same question. How is that LEDs are current-driven and not voltage-driven? Or why I can't connect an LED directly to a battery? Okay, most people understand the concept of voltage. Everybody knows that you cannot power a 12-volt LED strip off a 220-volt outlet. You cannot run it off a AA battery either. Every device has a certain voltage rating specified by the manufacturer, and it must be powered using a supply that outputs exactly this voltage. So why are LEDs different, and why are they current-driven? Thing is that voltage and current go side by side, and each depends on the other. The relation between them is established by the well-known Ohm's law. To put it simply, as the voltage increases, the current also increases, but the nature and rate of this increase can be different, depending on the load connected. So we can say that some devices require voltage stabilization, while the others need current stabilization. We all know that an incandescent light bulb can be plugged directly into a wall outlet without drivers or resistors. But an LED is not a light bulb, and it behaves differently in an electrical circuit, so it needs to be powered differently. In this video, I will show you a simple experiment that clearly demonstrates how an LED differs from a light bulb. This is Ron Mattino. We will use a voltage regulator to power an LED and a regular light bulb connected in parallel. We will observe the current flowing through each of them separately using 2 ammeters, and the voltage, which will be the same for both, using a multimeter. So, this is a DC-DC step-down converter board set to output 3.28 volts. This is the LED. The current that flows through it is shown on this ammeter. And this is the light bulb. We can see its current on this ammeter. Now I'll slowly increase the voltage. Let's see what happens. At 3.45 volts, the LED current has almost doubled, affecting its brightness. However, the light bulb current remained pretty much the same. Now I am decreasing the voltage. At 3 volts, the LED current dropped almost by half. The lamp current, however, again changed insignificantly. The rate of this change even slows down, because as the spiral heats and expands, its resistance drops. Throughout our experiment, the lamp resistance fluctuated only within half an ohm, but miracles happened with the LED. A 6% change in voltage made the current double. Its resistance ranged from 4.7 to 18 ohms, that's almost 5 times. But Ohm's law tells us that the increase in current must be proportional to the increase in voltage. Have we just made an incredible scientific discovery? Not really. The relation between current flowing through a load and voltage across this load is called the VI characteristic. A diode is a semiconductor device with a nonlinear VI. As the supply voltage increases, the LED's resistance drops, which makes current increase much faster than voltage. If I kept on turning this potentiometer, at some point the current would peak and the LED would fail, while the lamp would feel perfectly fine. Our little experiment also demonstrates that LED brightness is proportional to the current passing through it. Let's replace the light bulb with another LED. What do we see? Both LEDs are powered from the same source, so they get the same voltage, 3.3 volts. However, this LED current is 280 milliamps, while this one's is 330 milliamps, and it's brighter. Why? The reason is simple. Not all LEDs are produced equal. Their VI characteristics may differ. So, to power our diodes properly, we must ensure current is stabilized. There are 2 ways to do it. Use a driver circuit, or simply attach a resistor in series. Let's try the resistor method. Here I have attached identical resistors in series with each LED. As expected, the current dropped on both devices. But lo and behold, we can now see the current flowing through the diodes has almost leveled off. And while I'm raising the voltage, current increases equally on both LEDs. So what happened here? When an LED has a resistor in series, the V voltage is divided between them proportionally to resistance, which means larger resistance component gets larger voltage. When I increase the V1 increase is insignificant, because the LED resists it by decreasing its resistance, and stopping the V1 from rising. But the V equals V1 plus V2 equation is always true, and the V2 has to increase. So, thanks to the resistor, the LED can limit the voltage across its terminals. The remaining voltage is dissipated on the resistor. If you need to use several LEDs, it makes sense to wire them in series. We know that in serial connection, all components carry the same current, which is exactly what we need. But you have to keep in mind that your power supply voltage must be enough for the LEDs to turn on. For example, you can't use a 5-volt power supply to power two LEDs. This is the reason why 12-volt LED strips usually have three diodes connected in series with a resistor. Each LED gets a maximum of 4 volts in this case. Then these triodes are connected in parallel, and each has its own resistor. If the strip is powered by 24 volts, 6 LEDs can be used. A 48-volt LED strip can have 12 LEDs, etc. And that's it for today. If you like this video, please share it on social media and hit the like and subscribe buttons. And if you wish to drop me some crypto, please check out the description section. This was Ron Mattino. See you soon.